Welcome to Learn Instrumentation Engineering YouTube channel. Today we are going to detailly discuss about instrument air compressor system. So what is basically an instrument air compressor and what are the different equipments available in instrument air compressor and the purpose of each equipment would be detailed in this video. And before going into this video, in our channel Learn Instrumentation Engineering YouTube channel, we discuss on basic and fundamental concepts of instrumentation engineering and control system. We would also cover technical updates which is happening globally in and around industrial instrumentation and automation. Also, we are covering latest technical news which is centering around instrumentation. So if you are an instrumentation student or a working professional or even an expertise in the field of instrumentation engineering, do subscribe to our channel Learn Instrumentation Engineering. Okay, let's get into this video. Okay, this is the instrument air compressor detailed view. Okay, first let's quickly go through the different types of equipments and we will detailly discuss on the purpose of each and every equipments. In an instrument air compressor system, first we do have an intake filter. So that would filter the atmospheric air and it let into the compressor suction. So once the compressor discharged the atmospheric air into instrument air, it gets into the cooler system. Basically, it cools down the compressed air and then it gets into the receiver. So from the receiver, it stores the compressed instrument air and then it gets into the air dryer system where it absorbs all the moisture in the instrument air system. And finally, it gets into the main header through the dust filters. So when the instrument compressed air is available in the main header, that would be free of moisture, dust, highest quality of instrument air. Okay, let's detailly see the equipment purposes one by one. First, let's see what is basically intake air filter. There are two important things that has to be taken care of while designing and installation of instrument air compressor system, and that would be detailed in the intake air filter itself. So the important purpose of the air filter is to filter the ambient air. Okay, since it filters the air, the location of installation of this air filter is very, very important, because the location of air filter should be away from sources of moisture, dirt, flammable gases and corrosive gases. So the location of air intake filter is very, very important, because the instrument air should not carry any of these items that is going to be fed into any hydrocarbon area inside the process plant. And next important thing that has to be taken care of is the location of instrument air compressor or the filter should be installed in the coolest location of the process facility or the plant, because the temperature of ambient air plays a major role after the discharge of compressed air. So it would be better if the instrument air compressor or the intake air filter is located in the coolest location of the plant. So this is basically the intake air filter system. Next, let's see the compressor. Basically, the compressor does is it compresses the atmospheric air into an instrument air. Okay, so basically the atmosphere air pressure is 14.7 psi. So the compressor does is that it compresses the atmospheric air into instrument air, and that would compress to a nominal range of 10 bar pressure. And some of the process facility, they do have a range of more than 10 bar as well. So this is a nominal range of compressor discharge pressure. And in many of the process facilities, they use screw compressor, and we do also have reciprocating compressor in some of the process facility as well. But in major industries, they use screw compressor for its efficiency performance. Okay, next important equipment is after cooler. So what is basically an after cooler? See, once the instrument air is compressed, okay, It absorbs a lot of heat from the system, and also we knew that PV is directly proportional to RT. So when the ambient atmospheric pressure is increased, it would also increase the temperature. So this is the reason that we should absorb the heat from the compressed instrument air. So we can achieve this by two methods. One is by air fan and other is by water as a cooling medium. Since the temperature drops, we should use auto drain valve or moisture trap valve to catch the condensed liquid from the instrument air. So these are all the important things that comes in air after cooler. And next we would be seeing air receiver. So in some of the instrument air compressor system, the air receiver is being located in the downstream of instrument air dryer. But in some of the process facilities, the instrument air receiver is installed in the upstream of instrument air dryer. The best practices that we would tell is that the instrument air receiver should be installed in the upstream of instrument air dryer. We would tell what is the main purpose of this, because the air receiver acts as a knockout drum to prevent liquid entry into the dryer. Basically, it is also called a snuggle drum because it dampens compressor output pulsation. We all know that from the compressor output, we do have a lot of pulsation, and this knockout drum would dampen, and that would be very useful to remove the further moisture carryover in the instrument air. And the another important thing that we should know in air receiver is that it should have a drain valve in the bottom. It is best if it is an auto drain valve, because it should periodically drain the moisture which has been settled down in the bottom of the air receiver. So it should periodically discharge the collected water in the air receiver bottom. So this is basically an air receiver. And finally, we would see the dryer. Generally, dryer will further absorb the moisture carryover in the instrument air receiver. So you would be asking a generic question if you are an instrumentation beginner student. Why should this much system is being taken care to remove the moisture air in each and every stage? Because if the moisture is not absorbed properly, and if it gets into the process facility, the instrument air would be having that moisture, and that would get into the shutdown valves, control valves, and other pneumatic system that would cumulatively damage the system and deteriorate the lifetime of the equipment. And that is why we ensure the moisture carryover is very less when it leaves the instrument air compressor. So how are we achieving to remove the moisture in the instrument air? We do have two dryers. We do have two dryer tower, and we would name that as A and B. If tower A is in a drying stage and tower B would be in regeneration. This is a separate topic that I would detail discuss about the full sequence of dryers. So one dryer would be in drying stage and the other tower would be in regeneration. We use regenerative desiccants like silica gel or activated alumina. So normally the dryer do is it frequently checks the set point of dew point. Okay. So the dew point would be ranging from minus 10 to minus 40 degrees Celsius. For example, if we set minus 40 as a set point, that tower A and B would try to achieve dew point minus 40 to have a quality instrument air. Okay, so this is basically the dryer. So in this video, we have seen fully about instrument air compressor equipments and the purpose of each and every equipment. So hope you got a very good knowledge over the instrument air compressor system. If this video was very useful to you, please hit the like button and share to instrumentation community. If you want to watch such instrumentation video, do subscribe to our channel, Learn Instrumentation Engineering YouTube channel. Thank you.